हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन एक्यूट इन्फ्लामेशन टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट द बैक्टीरिया और फेगोसोम फेगोसोम और बैक्टीरिया इज एनगल्फ्ड बाय दिस डब्ल्यूबीसीज एंड दिस इज लाइसोसोम विच इज प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द डब्ल्यूबीसीज। आफ्टर एनगल्फिंग द बैक्टीरिया फेगोसोम इनसाइड द डब्ल्यूबीसीज, दिस बैक्टीरिया और फेगोसोम विल बी किल्ड बाय द डब्ल्यूबीसीज। सो फॉर द किलिंग ऑफ दिस बैक्टीरिया देर आर a process which is known as the killing of the bacteria. This killing of the bacteria is having of two types. One is the oxygen dependent killing and second is the oxygen independent killing. Now we are discussing about the oxygen dependent killing of the bacteria. What is oxygen dependent killing of the bacteria? The killing of the bacteria which is dependent upon the lysosomal enzyme and lysosomal enzyme using oxygen for killing the bacteria. This is the oxygen dependent killing. The killing of the bacteria which is dependent upon the lysosomal enzymes and these lysosomal enzymes are using oxygen for killing these bacteria. This is the process of the oxygen dependent killing. Oxygen dependent killing of the bacteria. Now we are discussing about the mechanism of the oxygen dependent killing of the bacteria. What is the mechanism of the killing of the bacteria which is oxygen dependent killing? For example, this is the membrane of the this WBCs. This is the membrane of the WBCs, and in membrane there is present NADPH oxidase enzyme. It is the membrane of the WBCs. WBCs or neutrophils membrane. And this NADPH oxidase enzyme is also known as the phagocyte oxidase. Why it is called the phagocyte oxidase? Because it is present in the membrane of the WBCs or the phagocyte. So it is also called phagocyte oxidase enzyme. And this NADPH oxidase enzyme having two components. One is membrane bound components and second is the cytosomal component. For example, this is NADPH oxidase and the part which is contact with the cytosome, this part is known as the cytosomal component, and outside the part which is present outside from the cytosome, it is known as the membrane bound component. So two component, one is the membrane bound component and second is the cytosomal component. Cytosomal component of the phagocyte oxidase or NADPH oxidase. This NADPH oxidase enzyme is utilizing oxygen and converting into the superoxides. These are the superoxide O2-, and these superoxide get converted into the hydrogen peroxide, and these hydrogen peroxide converted into the HOCl. What is HOCl? HOCl is a free radical, hypochlorous free radical. And the conversion of the H2O2 into the HOCl is done by the MPO enzyme. What is MPO? The myeloperoxidase enzyme. And this free radical HOCl, this free radical will cause the free radical injury. And due to this free radical injury, the phagosome or bacteria will be killed. And this WBCs or the lysosomal enzyme NADPH oxidase enzyme is utilizing oxygen for the killing of the bacteria. So there is increased utilization of the oxygen by the WBCs. So the conversion of the oxygen into superoxide is also increased. H2O2 is also increased and HOCl increased. All these are increased. So killing of the bacteria is increased. So there is increased demand of the oxygen by the WBCs. This is known as the respiratory burst. And due to the respiratory burst, the enzyme NADPH oxidase is also known as the NADPH oxidase enzyme is known as the respiratory burst oxidase enzyme. If the NADPH oxidase enzyme is decreased, or the concentration of the NADPH oxidase enzyme is decreased in WBCs, then it will lead to the chronic granulomatous disease, CGD, chronic granulomatous disease. Now we discuss about the chronic granulomatous disease. CGD. What is the reason of the CGD? Because the NADPH oxidase enzyme is defected or decreased. So it will cause the chronic granulomatous disease. And this chronic granulomatous disease having two types. One is X-linked recessive chronic granulomatous disease and second is autosomal recessive. Two types. One is X-linked recessive chronic granulomatous disease and second is the autosomal recessive chronic granulomatous disease. What is the reason of the X-linked recessive CGD? It is caused due to the defect in the membrane bound component of the NADPH oxidase enzyme. Membrane bound component of the NADPH oxidase. And this membrane bound component of the NADPH oxidase is also known as the glycoprotein 91 phagocyte oxidase. GP91 FOX glycoprotein 91 phagocyte oxidase. And what is the region of the autosomal recessive CGD? It is due to defect in cytosomal component. Defect in cytosomal component of the NADPH oxidase enzyme. It will cause the autosomal recessive chronic granulomatous disease. Now, what are the clinical manifestation of the chronic granulomatous disease? Clinical manifestation of chronic granulomatous disease. There are two clinical manifestations of the chronic granulomatous disease. One is the recurrent infection and second is the granuloma formation. Now we talk about the recurrent infection. First is the recurrent infection. What is the reason of the recurrent infection? Because the pathogenic bacteria not be killed. Why the pathogenic bacteria not be killed? Because there is defect in the NADPH oxidase enzyme. So there is no formation of the free radical, no free radical injury, and bacteria not be killed. So there is recurrent infection. Bacteria not be killed means bacteria present. And this recurrent infection is caused by the catalase positive organism. By catalase positive organism. For example, the Staphylococcus aureus and Pseudomonas. Only some species of the Pseudomonas, not all. And Nocardia. Why only the catalase positive organism can cause infection in this patient? Because the oxygen is converting into the superoxide by the NADPH oxidase, NO. And we know that in chronic granulomatous disease, this NADPH oxidase enzyme is defected. So this pathway is blocked. This is major pathway and this major pathway is blocked. So the oxygen is converting into the superoxide by the a minor pathway by the bacterial oxidase enzyme. Bacterial oxidase. This pathway is already blocked and this superoxide is converting into the H2O2, and this H2O2 in catalase positive organism. Catalase positive organism converted into the H2, which is harmless, and there is no free radical, means no free radical injury. FR injury is absent, so the bacteria will not be killed. Bacteria present. And what happening in organism other than the catalase positive organism? organism other than the catalase positive, for example the streptococcus. The H2O2 is converting into the HOCl, hypochlorous, by the help of the MPO, myeloperoxidase enzyme. And this HOCl, which is a free radical, will cause the free radical injury and the streptococcus will be killed. And in catalase positive organism there is no formation of the free radical, so the catalase positive organism will not be killed. So the catalase positive organism can cause infection in the patient of the chronic granulomatous disease. The recurrent infection is caused by only the catalase positive organism. Other than catalase positive, for example, streptococcus is killed by the free radical injury. And this phenomena is used in disinfectants. How? In disinfectants, we use bleaching powder. With the water, and when bleaching powder react with the water, it will produce hypochlorous, which is free radical, and this free radical will cause the free radical injury and the organism will be killed. So we use disinfectants by the free radical injury. We use free radical injury in disinfectants. Now we talk about the diagnosis of the chronic granulomatous disease. There are two tests available for the diagnosis of the chronic granulomatous disease. One is NBT test. What is NBT? The nitro blue tetrazolium test. NBT test. In NBT test, we use the NBT dye. Which is colorless. The NBT dye is colorless. And normally in our body some quantity of the oxygen radical is always present, because the NADPH oxidase enzyme is present in our blood. So the NADPH oxidase enzyme will produce the oxygen free radical in our blood. So free radical always present in our blood. And when this NBT dye will react with the free radical, it will form the formazone. And this formazone is blue to purple color. And the production of the blue to purple color is indicate that this is positive test. Positive NBT test. And this happens in normal person. And what will happen in the chronic granulomatous disease patient? In chronic granulomatous disease patient, there is defect in the NADPH oxidase. So the conversion of the oxygen into the superoxide will not occur, So there is no formation of the free radical. So the reaction of the NBT with the free radical will not occur. So there is no formation of the formazone and there is no color. So this is negative test. Negative test, which indicate the chronic granulomatous disease. Second test for the diagnosis of the chronic granulomatous disease is the flow cytometry test. Flow cytometry test. In flow cytometry test, we use DHR instead of the NBT dye. DHR. What is DHR? Dihydrorhodamine. Dihydrorhodamine. Instead of the NBT dye, we use dihydrorhodamine. And this flow cytometry test is better than the NBT test. Why it is better? Because in NBT test, the NBT test, it depends upon the experience of the user, and it depends also time for dye. It depends upon the time which using the dye. But the most easily available test for the CHD is the NBT test. The NBT test is most easily available. Available test for the CGD patient. Thank you.